Good morning, ducks! Good morning, everybody, and welcome to the Duck Adventure for, I think it's the 16th. Doug's out of commission, guys. He's got a couple days off.
He can't go outside. I gotta keep him inside. His foot is too bad. He's ripped his paw right off the bottom. The bottom right off his paw. I'm beat, guys. What a day yesterday. The ducks wouldn't go in last night for me. I had to, it was unbelievable what I had to go through to get them back into the pen. It was nuts here, yes. I can't believe what it turned out like. Probably one of the harder days that I've had here. Plus with all the predator action. So the ducks aren't getting out of the pen either today. I'm going to, I have to get the weed whacker out, and I have to cut the other side of the creek. The coyotes are using the cover of the bulrushes on the other side of the creek to hunt the ducks. I saw it myself yesterday, two coyotes to boot. So, and I never got a shot off. They never came into the yard last night. So I'm thinking they're the young ones. Because the fact that I saw the you know, like the ducks were right there at the shallow end of the creek, and the coyote was having a hard time catching them because he never caught one. I watched, and he left with nothing in his mouth. Well, I didn't watch. I saw it happen, and I don't stand there and watch. I react rather quick, actually. He never caught one, and the second one didn't catch one either, because as soon as he saw me, he left. And I stood there in the rain for so long. Well, put it this way, my flashlight on my my rifle, the little pressure switch, got full of water. And last night I woke up to a big blinding red light in my bedroom, and I was the switch, I don't know if it's screwed or not, but it was stuck on. Then I got playing with a flashlight at 3 a.m. and I could hear the water. I was squeezing the switch and I could hear the water inside the switch. So I think I have to buy another switch, because I'm not thinking it's going to dry out. But the ducks aren't getting out today. So the pen's clean, though. So they're going to be just there. Actually, I should have left them in the pen yesterday so that I wouldn't have to go through what I went through yesterday. They destroyed my yard. Absolutely the worst destruction I've ever seen the ducks do to the yard. They turned a massive area into mud. It was a bad day. Plus, I have to haul a bunch of gravel to a couple posts. There was so much water yesterday that we have some serious post holes, sinkholes around the posts. Everything settled yesterday. It was a lot of water came down here. So the plan of action today is weed whacking with the brush cutter on the other side of the creek. Plus, I'm going to do a little bit of on this side of the creek on the path that the ducks walk. I'm not going to do a lot because I want to get back to that pen. Actually, let me just check the weather, because when I went to bed last night, they were talking that today was going to be a 60% chance of rain, and now there's no chance of rain. Oh, there is a little. There's 40% chance north of us, so, but it's still hit and miss. Beautiful weather, 29, 30 coming. So, I'll get back on the pen tomorrow. Today is going to be a weed whacking day. Oh man, I should say bulrush cutting day. I hate those days. But I got to do the other side of the creek, because of the fact that Doug, I can't let Doug outside. He can't. That foot of his, that's going to take a couple days, 3-4 days actually, before it starts healing. I don't know what I'm going to do here. Like honestly, guys, I don't know what I'm going to do other than leave the ducks locked up. I can't let the ducks out because I got no protection. And I can't patch his foot up, like put a big bandage on his foot, because the air needs to get to it so that it'll dry out and heal. Because if, on a paw injury like that, if it stays wet, the pad doesn't develop. I've gone through this before. I've had lots of dogs in my life, and they always cut their feet, it seems, when they're running through the bush. Unless they get air, the pad stays raw. I've seen it countless times. So Doug's right now sleeping on the bed upstairs, and I'm just gonna leave him. he can sleep the day away. But tomorrow, back to the pen. I'm going to plan on getting up early. I might not even do any filming. I might just get up and go. So that's what's going on here. Not very exciting stuff, I can tell you that right now. And poor Dougie. He's upstairs sleeping on the bed. He's so, oh, I could just go up and snuggle him, stay with him. I'm so tired myself, but he's going to enjoy this. But I can't let the ducks out. And right now the swamp is full of mud. Like, the ducks would have a blast in the mud down there. They would play the whole day in the mud. The swamp is flooded, which is going to make it tricky cutting the bulrushes. All right, I got to get my edit done and go out and start cutting bulrushes.
Look at this dog. Oh, he knows he's hurting. And he's playing it up here. You got some time off, Doug.
It sure looks like you're enjoying it.
Man, you take up a lot of the bed.
I'm gonna go out and do my morning duck chores. It's about 9:30, quarter to 10, finish my edit, and then I'm gonna go and start doing some bulrush cutting, I should say. Not what I want to be doing, but I got to do that because Doug's MIA here on his job. So until I can let him out and run, I gotta do some predator clearing so that I can work on the pen. Because I can't let the ducks out because they'll go to the swamp. And, you know, right now it's like perfect. After what I saw yesterday, it's perfect for hunting for the coyotes. Well, this isn't gonna be good because the ducks are gonna think they're getting out and I can't let them out. So we're gonna have a bit of a rush to the front of the pen. But I got to get some feed for the little ducks because I know their feeder is going to be stripped, and freshen up the water here. No ducks, you aren't coming out. And I absolutely can't let them out. Not with what I saw here yesterday. I don't see any hurt ducks. It's looking good. All right, I'm gonna do the water, get some feed for the babies and the, you know, the turtle ducks, our snapping turtle hurt victims, and get on with my day here. Poor ducks. And the thing is, right now, you know, the yard is perfect for them to go and play in. Man, are they loud. But I've got to cut all those bulrushes down the other side of the creek. It has to happen today. Because if I want to work on the pen with Doug in the house sleeping, because he has to sleep, his foot is just too torn up. I've got to make it a little more difficult for the coyote. Because yesterday, you know, I watched that coyote, you know, trying to get the duck, and he didn't. I saw that. He left empty mouth. He didn't have any luck. I think it's the young ones, actually. Oh, as far as the snapping turtle, guys, the cage is empty. You know, the trap is empty. I think it's probably going to empty this morning. Because think about this. We haven't had a snapping turtle victim in, what, 10 days? It's been a while. So the fact that we're not getting any snapping turtles, you know, hurting the ducks, or no, ducks getting hurt by snapping turtles right now, makes sense why the trap is empty. Because where I've got the trap is exactly where I have seen two ducks getting attacked by turtles. You know, turtle or turtles, I don't know, but that is the exact spot.
like the exact spot. Actually, it's dead between. It's right. It's dead in between the spots where I saw the two ducks getting attacked. So I'm thinking the turtle has moved to another part of the lake, and that's the only reason why we haven't seen them. And as far as using, you know, dead ducks as bait, the ducks, the reason the ducks are getting attacked by the turtles is because their feet are moving. And the turtles see the feet moving in the water and it looks like fish to them. Because really, turtles love fish. That's what they go by, is the smell of rotting dead fish or even a live fish. But the duck feet is what's attracting the ducks, you know, or the turtles. And they grab the feet and then they drown the duck, or they just maim the duck, you know. So, you know, right now, the minnows I'm using is the best bait that I can ask for. All right, let me get my chores done here, because I still got an edit to finish, and I got to get out and cut a whole bunch of bulrushes today.
I'm really sorry, ducks. Man, they're loud. But it's only for one day. Hopefully tomorrow I can let you out. Come on, let me have the hose. And these poor little guys, they really ran the gauntlet yesterday of the coyote action. I used them as bait yesterday, because when they were playing in the exact area that I saw the coyote, I stood behind the birch tree for like an hour, waiting, getting soaked in that rainstorm, hoping that I was going to catch a shot. And these little guys were my bait, but coyote didn't show up. I know their feeder's empty this morning, because these guys are really starting to crank up the feed consumption. There's little Bill. He was the only smart one yesterday that came in out of the rain. All right, I gotta get the water happening here. All right, what's going on in here, ducks? The duck in the far corner. Her nest moves all over the place. I know I keep saying this, but I gotta clean this building up. Real soon. Not gonna happen today, though. I gotta cut bulrushes. Alright, let's get some feed for the babies. We're getting low on this, guys. Basically, when this pile's gone, the little ducklings will be living with the flock. And hopefully I'll have the pen done. I will. Honestly, if it wasn't for the rain yesterday, the pen would be done. And today, I gotta take care of the predator problem. Well, not take care of the predator. Well, maybe I will, but I gotta make it harder for them. Feeders will be stripped, though. Hello, ducks. Actually, I need to clean this today. I can't believe the duck feces. Well, I'll clean this before I go to the swamp to cut bulrushes. Oh, boys. All right, I'm going to give them a little bit of feed to get them through until I clean this. Just look how small Bill is over there. But that duck was the only smart one yesterday in the rainstorm. Came right back inside. Okay, duckies, I'm going to give you some food. That'll give them a little bit of a snack until I can come back and clean this. And I definitely have to clean it, because actually I feel a burning in my eyes. I just clean this. But then again, you know, they're all trapped in here because of the rain. Okay, I gotta go finish my edit and then come back out here. Clean this up. Oh, I got the water running. Totally forgot about that. If that little frog goes into the pen, it's gonna be a duck snack. Don't go that direction. Almost forgot my camera and the water running. Well, let's check the turtle trap before I go back in and finish my edit. I gotta cut all of that. It's gonna be a trick too, because it's really tricky walking. Soft stuff. And with all the rain we've had, it's gonna be, oh man. If it was dry like it was there last week, it would be like half as much time. Okay, oh, ground's really floating. See, right now the water level's probably up about 4 or 5 inches higher. Look at that, it's like Jell-O. Oh, is she ever Jell-O right here? Okay. Nothing. A ton of minnows though. Holy molies, there's a lot of minnows. A ton of minnows. And guys, you know, as far as using duck as bait, the only reason the turtles are attacking the ducks is because their feet are moving in the water. And the ducks and the turtles think it's fish. And that's why they grab them. And then they drown them or maim them. Oh, boys, look at this. I'm sinking bad here. Water level's way up. Oh boy, it's getting harder to get the drop out. Drop. Oh boys, I'm sinking totally here. Yeah, door works. Just there's nothing here right now. It's going to be a real trick cutting today. All right, I got to go do my edit and then come out here and probably spend 5 to 7 hours on the end of a weed whacker cutting bulrushes. Well, my dog's inside sleeping. We'll see how it goes today on the cutting. I might be able to squeeze in a little bit of cutting right here, but I know I have to cut on the other side of the creek, absolutely for sure. I saw the predators using them yesterday for cover, which made it quite difficult for me to take a shot because they just appear really fast out of the bulrushes. Oh boy, is this ever soft. The whole swamp's floating right now on the water we got. It rained hard. Oh, I'm so beat. Yesterday it wiped me out with all the crap that happened here. So much happened here yesterday. It was, I thought it was going to be an easier day. I shouldn't think that, you know, here, because every time I do, that's when the crap happens.
Look at that. They saw me walk by the pen, and now they're all coming up to the front again, thinking that, oh, maybe he's going to let us out. Sorry, ducks, not today. It ain't gonna happen.
Which, if you think about it, guys, it's lucky that, one, I cleaned the pen out, and then that massive rainstorm gave it another rinse out, because the pen's nice and clean, so the ducks aren't in a disgusting pen. I got the barn door open, but I don't even feel good about having it open because of that coyote action, and that Doug isn't out here, so I'm basically gonna be sitting in front of a computer for the next 2 hours. Close this door. Last thing I need is a coyote come in here and jump in the 4 foot barrier inside. And you never know. You gotta be on the ball when the crops starts happening like this. I've seen it too many times. Make a mistake and give the predator a window of opportunity and something dies.
Dog. Now he's rolling over to this side of the bench. Are you comfy, dog?
It's 11 o'clock. You're still sleeping. Enjoy it. Poor dog.
He's hurt. He's allowed to be a lazy dog.
The poor ducks are losing it, guys.
I haven't done much today. I'm doing my laundry. And I'm up here folding my laundry. Well, taking out the line and folding it. And the ducks are just cracking up. I didn't do any bull rushes today, guys. I'm actually following Doug's lead. I'm burned out. But I am going to go clean the barn out. I got to get it done. And I think what I'm going to do tomorrow morning is I'm going to let the ducks out and right then go down and start cutting those bull rushes and then get back onto the pen. But I burnt right out. I couldn't believe it. I don't know if it was because I kept checking on Doug and he was doing nothing. I was like, oh man, maybe I should be doing that too. But I'm going to finish my laundry here and then I'm going to go and shovel duck poop out of the barn.
I'm sorry I'm tormenting you ducks, but I gotta fold my laundry here. Poor ducks. Still better than getting hunted in the swamp though. I think yesterday with the rain and all the predator crap that happened to me, I think it wore me out. Because I'm absolutely wiped out today.
Oh, he's in the living room now. Oh, Dougies, you are being really lazy. Do you realize it's 3:45?
I don't believe you.
You are unbelievably laid back today. Relaxing, dog.
Doug is a bad influence. I think that's what it is. I'll blame it on him. I'm going to do some barn cleaning, do my duck chores. I still haven't done my edit. Well, I've got about half an hour into it. I've got about an hour and a half to go. But I'm just wiped out today. Absolutely. I did not realize yesterday all the stuff that happened to me. It wore me out. Too much happened here yesterday. Too much. So I'm going to do my duck chores. And I'm going to get the weed whacker ready. Sharpen up the blade. Change the spark plug. Because I know I burnt the spark plug out last time. And then tomorrow when I let the ducks out, I'm going to go out there and do some cutting. And then the next day, I'm back to the pen. I'm just slightly behind. All right, I'm going to do some duck poop shoveling in the barn. You know, if I wasn't such a responsible person, I wouldn't do this. Because honestly, guys, I feel as lazy as Doug is right now. I could so easily lay down and go to sleep. But I gotta do this. I'm sorry, ducks. Tomorrow morning I'll let you out. Is I can't see anything coming to attack them if I'm down there cutting the bulrushes. Oh, there's Bill. I'm coming to clean the barn out. Oh, boys, it stinks in here. All right, ducks. Outside so I can clean this out. Well, it looks like the 40% chance of showers is coming. I got some dark clouds moving in. Like we didn't get enough rain yesterday. Come on, ducks. Get outside. Come on. Get out. Get out. Go outside. Makes my job easier if you're outside. Okay. Going back and forth isn't going outside. Out. Get out. Out, ducks. It's like trying to get Doug outside. The rain made this bad yesterday because I locked them in here. But they were hard to get into here yesterday. Oh, boys. All they wanted to do was stand in the rain. And it was just, it was too crazy of a day with the predators yesterday. And plus, they kept wanting to go back down to the creek on me. You know, it was like they discovered the creek and they just wouldn't leave. While I was shooting rounds off down there and they wouldn't even come back then. So tomorrow when I let them out, I'm gonna go down there and do some cutting. I got a feeling I've done this before, guys. I think I've done a lot of videos on this. The not glamorous part of the duck adventure. And it was just starting to
get that ammonia burn just starting. Like by tomorrow morning, would it be nasty in here? Because there's a faint burn smell of ammonia. Just a faint right now. Nothing like the other day. I better close this gate, because now that they've experienced outside, they'll make a break for it. Yeah, I know, little ducks. Off to the apple tree. What a shame what the chipmunks are doing here. Oh, yes. I see in the comments, people keep telling me I need to put, you know, some kind of block system cone. We call them squirrel cones here. The problem is, if you look at the bottom of this apple tree, it's more like an apple bush. It's not a tree. And the problem is, how do you put a cone around that many trunks? Believe me, if it was one single trunk, I would have put a squirrel cone on this tree a long time ago. But I can't figure out how to put a squirrel cone on that many trunks in this area. That is the problem. And I've got a tree that's fallen down here. You know, it's not that warm out, but holy molies, the humidity's crazy. I can't believe how much I'm sweating. Ducks, what are you doing in here? The little quacks. I seem to be doing this an awful lot. I think it's because of the late hatch this year. Because normally I'm not cleaning the barn this much this late. Sweat is just pouring down my face right now. Humidity is absolutely crazy. I love how the smell goes away instantly. But it's so humid out, guys, even the ducks won't come in for fresh straw. This is the only group that would come in. The rest outside panting. It's sticky. I'm just sweating like crazy. I have to take my pivot heads off because where the arms of the glasses touch the side of my head, the sweat's just pouring down the side of my neck. It's really, really wet feeling. It's downright uncomfortable if you had to do a bunch of work. All right, go fill the feeder up in the pen and freshen up the duck water. They see me coming over and they think they're getting out. Unfortunately not. Look at this, resting their heads on the gate. Oh, please let us out. Oh, ducks. Oh, this is going to be a trick getting through the gate. I'm going to have to go backwards here. Look out, ducks. They're not too happy with me today. You'd almost think these ducks had never seen water before. Man, they're so funny. Well, they're ready for the night. I'm gonna go sharpen the weed whacker blade up and change the spark plug and get ready for tomorrow. They're all riled up because I'm in here. They were sleeping earlier. Females fighting. Nobody will come over to me. They're thinking about it, maybe. They're getting closer. They're curious, but they're cautious. Okay, ducks, let me through. Okay, there's still no sign of Doug at the door. Where is he? Oh. Okay, well now he's working his way out of the living room. He's laying in front of the window here. Doug. You're on disability right now. The dog has no urge to come outside.
Well, she's not bad, but it wouldn't hurt to give her a bit of a file. Make it a little bit sharper. Cuts much easier if it's really sharp.
Well, I'm ready for tomorrow. So tomorrow morning, that'll be the very first thing I do.
Well, I'll do the duck rush, let the ducks out, and go straight down to the swamp. Cut that side of the creek so the coyotes have no place to hide. But right now, I gotta go have a quick shower, and I gotta do tonight's edit. Just like I said, I got about an hour and a half ahead of me, so I'm hoping I can get it done and uploaded for you guys for tonight. And then start again tomorrow.
He's awake. Doug, do you want to come out? It's been almost 24 hours there, dog. Unbelievable, guys. It's 5:34. I'm thinking he came in last night, I think it was 8:30. So it's like 21 hours so far. His foot's got to be really sore.
It's got to be really sore, actually. He ripped off that pad. Because I know when he walks on his tiptoe on that back foot. Absolutely doesn't let his foot spread out at all. It's going to take probably a good week before it starts healing back. So I've got to be the duck protector. So I've got to come up with a system. Like, get the pen done so I can leave them locked up.
I'm still working on my edit.
And Doug has gone back upstairs to sleep. And yeah, he's gone back upstairs to sleep.
It's like 7:30. He still hasn't gone outside. Doug. Look at this dog. Oh, man. You're unbelievable today. 30 more minutes, Doug. I think you'll be 24 hours inside. Oh, man. You're lazy today. But it's all right because you're on disability.
Yeah, I think like another hour, 45 minutes, it'll be 24 hours since he's been inside.
and he has no urge. Like, I was working away, and I heard this creaking sound. I looked over, and I saw him, his back end disappear up the stairs, and I could hear the steps creaking. What a dog. I'll definitely have to kick him out, though, before I go to bed.
Well, 8:52, and the smell of roasted duck
finally brought Doug down. I'm actually going to kick him outside right now. Come on, Doug. You got to go outside for a pee. It's like 24 and a half hours. Come on. At least go to the bathroom. Do something. I'll let you in a second.
He's looking at me through the window. Oh, he just walked away. He's going to the bathroom. Unbelievable. 24 and a half hours, guys, inside the house.
And don't forget to like the video and share it with your friends. And enjoy the show.